I'd like to call to order the April 24th, 2017 meeting of the New Ulm Human Rights Commission. I think I would like to table number two. The mayor will bring that up under number eight today. Has everybody had a chance to look at the agenda? Are there any changes or updates?
No.
All right. Can I get a motion to approve the agenda?
So moved.
Second.
All right. Everybody get a chance to read the minutes?
Yes.
Any updates at all? Can I get a motion to approve the minutes?
So moved.
No, second.
Thank you. All right, we'll move on. Education Committee report, essay and poster contest. Would either of you like to?
Yeah, we, the Education Committee met and went through our posters and essays and determined winners for each category. We had a lot of posters, not as many essays this year, but we also didn't give them the time frame that we typically do, and the topic that we waited to get from the State Commission was maybe not as timely as we would have liked. It was about Martin Luther King Jr. Day, but we had it in April, so that I think factored into, but we still had four really good essays.
Yes.
And I don't know that...
Are we going to read the winning essay?
I was thinking about that, and I'd like to propose that when we invite the winners to come, that we maybe offered up that they could read their own.
Sure, mm-hmm. Good idea.
That's an excellent idea.
That's a great idea.
Mm-hmm. Plus, they haven't received an award letter, and then we're going to be reading it, so maybe it's getting the cart ahead of the horse, or the horse ahead of the cart.
Same for the poster, correct?
Poster, yes. So what we're going to do now is send out award letters to all the winners, and then invite them to the next meeting in May, where we'll do the presentations.
Excellent.
For the posters, maybe they can explain what the poster is or what they're thinking when they made the poster, too.
Yeah, I think that'd be a great idea.
Earlier, I think a couple of months ago, we had talked about possibly doing a video contest since it's becoming more popular to do short videos. I did Google some things about something we could do this summer, give the kids a little bit more time. It looks like June is Minnesota specific Immigrant Heritage Month, as long as Minnesota Pride Month, or as well as Minnesota Pride Month, World Environment Day, LGBTQ Pride Day, and Women's Equality Day are all also in the summer. Women's Equality Day is not until August. I kind of like the idea of sticking with the immigrant
theme.
Yeah, just to kind of keep things cohesive.
Yeah. And it's timely now with the government and what's going on, too. Mm-hmm.
I do want to make a correction, I believe, on this. The LGBTQ Pride Day, the parade day, parade is on the 25th, not the 26th.
But the day itself.
I got you. Okay.
Is the 26th, at least from the state website
gotcha.
That I found.
All right.
So I think we need to get this done before the May 22nd, since June is the Heritage Month. Can we get a vote on getting something together for
Were you thinking
a
of
video?
Of having the contest in the summer?
Well, or that it would be done, it would go through the end of June, and then we can make a decision.
Is it possible that some of the people that would participate would be using school equipment that they wouldn't have access to in the summer?
What about through the library?
Or through NUCAT.
Yeah, through NUCAT.
Okay.
Yeah, I was going to suggest.
There you go.
Yeah,
right.
A lot of them would use a cell phone.
Yeah, I suppose.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we take a vote on that? Do I have a motion?
So we would be making a motion sponsoring a video contest highlighting the Immigrant Heritage, Minnesota's Immigrant Heritage Month.
Yes, sir.
And this will be in June. What would be like the deadline?
The end of June.
Okay.
June 30th.
There's also money in the budget, $225, I believe, for prizes for a video contest. Mm-hmm. I think that the Education Committee could talk, between now and May 1st. And get an idea of what we want to write up to send to the schools again and go from there.
This is going to be for seniors and younger, or seniors in high school and younger, or
yeah, I think
who's going to be eligible for this?
I would think middle school on up. Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah. What's a good, you get an estimate of who all has cell phones. I know I have a 13-year-old that is good with a cell phone.
What you're saying, should we open it up to adults too?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking.
Because okay. I say, why not?
Yeah, I mean, I
think that's great. Yeah.
I don't think that's such a bad idea, frankly.
So then instead of strictly sending them to the schools, it could mm-hmm. be something that would come out in the paper?
Paper, yeah, publicized mm-hmm. everywhere.
That is.
Yeah. I'll make that a motion that we sponsor such a
community
video contest.
Second.
Excellent.
And that we...
Oh, can we also get a vote?
Yes.
So. Aye.
Aye. Yes, yeah. I'm sorry. I got all excited about the gavel. All opposed? All right, so that means we will, the education committee will get together and we will get a letter or a press announcement out to have June be Immigrant Heritage Month with a video contest.
And I think we still get the letters to the schools, though.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And that
yes.
we're going to get need to get
promoted,
on.
Yeah.
Like sure. a month left.
Yes.
After we're counting.
Who's going to be the chair for this project?
It'll be on the education.
Yeah. Okay. So education committee, we're going to need to meet soon.
Okay. Yes.
So
this may be able to be done via email, I believe.
We're going to need, yeah, we could. I was thinking we need to draft the letter and talk about specifics. You know,
also
this
a press
is something
release,
I've never done before. Yes.
Since so. We're inviting the community.
Mm-hmm. And what kind of
parameters
are we going to have? Yeah, right, parameters. What are we going
length
to
do? Length of the video.
Mm-hmm. So education
format.
Committee. I think we might have to meet.
We can do that.
So I'll send out an email and we'll get together. How's that
sounds
song?
Great.
Could I get the names of everybody on the education committee too? Because I was confused last time because we had some people switching, right? Because Laura, you...
I think
were, but
I
aren't.
One, yeah, events committee.
Right.
So I just don't want to miss anyone.
Events committee
so.
With you.
I think so.
That's Larry.
Tim Frenning, are you also?
I was on the events committee, Tindy. But I participated okay. in a lot of the education.
I thought I was on the events.
I'm willing to help with both.
Okay. So you're just on events?
I couldn't even tell you off the top of my head. That's okay. what I thought
See,
I was.
See, that's sad. I was listening to everybody.
I thought I was events, yeah.
Elder Tim, okay. Jackie, okay.
We need to probably clarify that all. I didn't know.
Yeah, we better go figure that out.
Yes, I will. I will send out an email with the list of who is on what committee. Yeah.
And I know yeah. I had it
I
in the minutes.
I just
a few months
yet.
Ago. I just don't remember what it was.
Jackie, I don't think I've been appointed to a committee yet.
Well, you're on both.
Okay.
Yes,
I have you down on the education right now, okay. So you're on it.
Just a suggestion on the video. Is it possible that we can get somebody from NUCAT to give us some? I know Alma, you've got a lot of experience doing videos, but perhaps we need somebody from NUCAT as well to kind of help us along and what the parameters would
Again,
be, what
I'll
we'd be looking for.
I'll talk to Steve and Ron. I don't know where they are because I think they're one man short right now.
Okay.
I don't know if they've hired somebody, so they might be pretty. Pretty
and you know those videos would be a fun thing to put on cable access as well.
I have some idea, but I'm not an expert.
Okay.
Well, and I could look too. I know other commissions have done similar things, so I'll see what I can.
Yeah, because I'd be interested to see: is it a short, like minute?
I would think
something, or is it more of a documentary?
Under 3 minutes would be should be enough time.
Well, if you before we meet can look at some.
If you're going to edit, it's
other.
It'll take you. They say at least a couple hours per minute if you're going to edit. So,
mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, that's if you're good at it.
Right.
Yeah.
All right, then that will be
Took me that long.
Discussed in that meeting. I think we can table number 6 due to Ron
uh-huh.
being out today. Number 7, community outreach. That was also Ron, but also Wendy for the letter to the editor.
Yeah, we're going to table that one too.
Okay.
Ron and I haven't found time to get together.
Mr. Mayor, would you like to address on the attendance requirement, please? And number 2.
To the best of my knowledge, there is no real, exact figure on attendance requirement.
There are people who have had to miss for various reasons, more than what I would like to see. Some of them are very, very active when they're here, but when they're in Arizona or Texas for to avoid the snow, if they're still doing their job other than attending the meetings, is that a bad thing? So as far as that is concerned, but I was concerned that Ray had not been here for any of the meetings.
Correct.
We were welcoming her at about, what, three meetings or four?
Four, mm-hmm. I believe.
And so I sent a letter, and I believe you received a copy of it.
Yes, sir.
And I don't think I was that negative. I was trying to be as positive as I could be. And today, Lisa Grothwell and I received a message. I received a letter earlier this month in regards to me missing meetings and if I was still interested on serving on the board. It's been a ridiculous winter with illness, my reasoning for missing last month's meeting, the family obligations. I'd also like to point out that I am pregnant into my eighth month and have little or no energy after the workday. I took on this role at a really hard time that I am more needed by my family. This time is also a very hard time due to my fiancé being a CPA, and he is typically not home till late every night, which has left issues on who's home with the kiddo during the times of HRC meetings. Due to my pending due date here in June, I won't be able to make meetings at all this summer. I feel that it's within my best interest, along with the interest of the HRC, that I resign from my position. So it's now official, and I have already spoken to Dan. And just to make sure I can find the information that I very carefully put away so I wouldn't lose it, he's going to send it to me again so that for next Tuesday's council meeting, hopefully will be a full commission.
Excellent. Thank you, sir.
And I would like to comment on your video plan and another thing that happened with our family. I have a daughter living in Elbert Lee who has a daughter. So my granddaughter is in grade school, and the grade school kids in Elbert Lee on Saturday all carried in a flag of the country that someone in the city of Elbert Lee is connected to. The choir that filled the stage, the elementary children that filled the stage, made two trips carrying flags. Wow. So Elbert Lee is not just an American city. It's not just a whatever. But there's, you name it, and there were countries that I had to listen pretty carefully to remember that there were even a country. Their statement was, if anybody is in the audience who has a tie to any country not represented, please let us know, and we will make sure that next year we will have your flag also here representing your ancestors' country. So I really thought that was fantastic. There had to be 100 different flags, and it was quite impressive, very, very impressive. A long drive for a six-minute concert, but, you know, that's what grandparents do. But that would be something that maybe not this year, but this might be something else that you can work with on the idea of where did your ancestors come from. Sure, we have a German-American Day parade, but there's a lot of New Ulm citizens that are neither German or were not born and raised here in America. They are now Americans, I would assume, I've been hoping, but yet their ancestry goes back to Somalia, Togo, and so on and so forth. So that just might be a little addition that you guys can be working on for a year from now even.
Mm-hmm. That's an excellent idea.
It is. Gorgeous. Thank you, sir.
One of our posters that we had, it was from a first grader, I believe, drew all the flags of the countries that just their family had connections to. Mm-hmm. And I want to say there were seven or eight flags mm-hmm. just on this one poster.
Oh, very cool.
So it's cool. I think we could build on that.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
Thank you.
Speaking of, put it down as your idea.
Flags. I had my own experience with a flag today. I was driving home for lunch, and I drove past a nice van with bull horns, long horns, steer horns, that were attached to the roof of the, or the hood. Also underneath it was a huge Confederate flag. Took up the whole van. I think it is. It is. But we've also talked about how to make people feel welcome here in New Ulm, and that's not a good way. I know there's nothing we can do, but it is out there. I think making everybody understand that this is still not always the most welcoming community, and to have a vehicle like that parked on the road is pretty loud and clear.
Did they have a Confederate flag at that celebration?
To the best of my knowledge, no. That's really not a country.
No.
It's not, but if I'm curious if someone brought one.
No, to the best of my knowledge, no. But I hear what you're saying. Mm-hmm. I saw a smaller one go by.
I've seen that on the back of a pickup truck, a couple of them in the back of a pickup truck as well. I know that for a while there have been some states that have requested them to be removed or not flown. Is there something in New Ulm that has that as well, or is it kind of just not been said?
There is nothing that I've been able to find that in the books that says the only flag you can fly is.
Yeah, it all goes back to freedom of speech.
Mm-hmm. It really does.
Mm-hmm. Just like the video that I didn't like a long time ago in UCAP, and the lawyer said that it was, you know, freedom of speech. I made the argument that it was hate speech. And the answer was, well, we rather deal with it later than stop it and be accused of
censorship.
Mm-hmm. Well, we combat things like that by doing projects like we're doing in just education,
right.
Letting people know that, okay, there are, you know, that there are more people that support
not doing that than doing that.
Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, I just think we need to be visible and make it okay to be visible.
Well, that's why I think we need to do more things like the suggestion the mayor had about the kids with the flags is a fabulous idea as well. I mean, it's these outreach things that we need to do into the community. That's why with the video, I also suggested the adults.
I agree.
I just think we need to do more of that as a commission here in New Ulm.
I just think this is a good reminder that because we surround ourselves with people that may be like-minded with like-minded values or feelings about the people around us, that there are people out there that don't.
Mm-hmm. Well, in you know, which flags you can fly. I fly the city flag under my national flag. Mm-hmm. But I've also seen several people having another flagpole somewheres in their yard that's flying the German flag.
Yeah.
Because that's where they were born. They're American citizens now, but they still have that tug back to Germany. And there are some people that have never been to Germany. I'm just using the word Germany. And still would like to fly a German flag because they have their ancestors' tug that says German or
that's
English or England, or whatever country it may be.
I would suggest they wouldn't have done that 60 years ago, though.
No.
Yeah.
No, not the German flag.
Some progress.
Yeah. Well,
not the German flag, for sure.
I think the German flag doesn't mean as much as it did maybe 60 or 70 years ago, mm-hmm. whereas today...
It's context.
Know,
right.
I don't think they'd be flying the Nazi flag today.
Well, that's, I hope
it's
not.
It has the same connotation as a Confederate flag.
Right.
Correct.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. And but at one time, I believe the Nazi flag was kind of the whole symbol of Germany, but there's a lot of people that didn't fly them.
No, right.
Mm-hmm. I think one of the things that we should consider doing, and I can't get a proposed list of events, There's some places where community organizations are invited, like the Night Out one time.
Because I know
the League
Night
of Women
Out,
Voter
yeah.
goes there and the Rose people. I think in the Women Expo too, I think, the home show. I think we should start thinking about having a booth there, the State Fair. Maybe that's where we can use those posters, which I don't know if I proposed to Jackie. But maybe we should do that with some of these beautiful posters that they're in the basement and we don't see them. And
maybe
just have a booth
the
in the
county fair,
the county fair mm-hmm. and the state the county fair. That's right, not state fair.
We
well,
will have
state
to
fair too, but,
in doing that, know? And I think that's a good idea as mm-hmm. well. But in doing that, I think we need to approach council again this year about increasing the budget because there's
oh,
always
right.
booth rental for
that's
things
right.
like that
that's
as
right.
well.
That's right.
But we do need uh-huh. to have a presence, I think, in the community mm-hmm. that way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So when is the budget get hammered out here, Mr. Mayor?
Probably
starting now.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, so I will contact and find out how much it costs to rent a booth.
But I'm not positive. I think for nonprofits it might be free. But I don't.
Some may be, but some may not be.
Oh. Okay. Not always.
Such as the home show and things like that.
Right.
But we can contact the chamber on that one. Yeah. They're the ones
okay.
who run that.
Okay.
So somebody is going to do that?
And Brown County Fair Board would be for the county fair.
Okay.
Yeah, and that would be something I would think would fall under the education
mm-hmm.
committee. And then we might want to talk about, because we typically don't meet in the summer, but these are going to be events through the summer.
So yeah, I think we're going to have to start meeting in the summer, especially with the video thing coming up in June.
I have that listed under number 10.
I saw that.
Oh, see, I didn't see that. Okay.
No more vacation.
No. I'm free. No. I'm good. Mm-hmm. I can even be here by 5 in the summer.
We had talked a little at the last meeting about new immigrant community members. Did we want
to? Well, we were going to, that was going to be the topic of our letter to the editor
okay.
that we are still working on.
Okay. So we will table that along with number 7.
A lot of tabled things with my name up.
So I have the date in the next meeting is May 22nd.
Before I wanted to say something.
Yes.
With the current human rights issues, I was thinking about my role as the legislative chairperson, and what you guys want to hear. I mean, the league, of course, I couldn't get any
right.
information. The Minnesota Department of Human Rights, they do have press releases, which I'm not sure would be of much interest to this commission. I do have what the latest press release. And as far as legislation goes, there are some bills right now being proposed in the House or in the Senate, or they're, you know, being discussed that directly affect human rights in one way or another. Is that something that you might be interested in me bringing and saying, well, and again, I'm not sure that they do are part of human rights. I don't know how much they do affect our community. I know, like, for example, the environmental and natural resources bills do affect us, and they are part of human rights. I mean, we part of the charter is everybody's entitled to food and clean water.
Mm-hmm.
So would you like me to prepare when I feel that they're applicable to human rights, to bring them, if nothing else, just I'm just unsure what that role is.
I'm thinking that my own opinion would be yes, because you're a conduit, let's say, mm-hmm. between what the state is doing and mm-hmm. here in New Ulm, and some of mm-hmm. us may not be aware of some of these bills that are out there.
Okay.
And a quick synopsis of some of those, I think, would be mm-hmm. just fine. I guess I would recommend we put legislative update on the agenda every month, mm-hmm. either Alma has something or she does not.
Yeah. Okay.
But I really do think that's a good idea to mm-hmm. Bring that out in the open.
Okay.
I think, too, since it's televised, that's education mm-hmm. to the
yeah,
community.
Correct.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. So we talked about May 22nd, summer schedule. We now know that we are pretty busy this summer. do we want to go all the way through? Do we want to, we'll need to meet in July for sure. Do we want August off? Or we're going to need to deal with stuff about students possibly for August. So I think especially this year.
I think it's a full year this year, personally.
Yeah, I agree.
Mm-hmm. And it was never a rule that we didn't meet. It was just there was nothing going on during the summer. So we can if we want to.
Mm-hmm. I think that.
I think we need to. I think that's been has been tripping us up as far as getting student representatives is once we get going, school's already started, and then we miss our window.
And I don't think we need to vote on that since it's not anything to be changed.
Yeah, so nothing has happened with the stuff that we talked about, the new charter or the new...
That's where Ron was.
That's when Ron, that's part of Ron. Okay.
Okay. Does anybody have anything they'd like to add at the end?
Oh, just that I was asked to mention the Minnesota Twin Cities, or the Central Minnesota Pride, Twin Cities Parade is June 25th, and you can contact, find information on that on Facebook, and then also on September 9th, the Southern Minnesota Pride will be having their festival in Mankato Riverfront Park. And we're all invited to that, and anybody out there listening is invited as well.
Thank you.
Would we consider having a booth there? They have booths of community organizations at the Southern Minnesota Pride.
I think we certainly could do something like that. I mean, let's face it, if you are, you know, I always forget the initials.
LGBTQ.
Yeah, LGBTQ. In a community like New Ulm, normally you will go to that bigger city because you're more, there's a more inclusive population there, if you will. Mm-hmm. And it might be nice to have some New Ulm folks there saying, hey, there's somebody here that can support you as well.
Mm-hmm. I can arrange that. I have a booth there for another organization too. So. Okay.
Did you have something to say, Alma?
Yeah, I did have information about three bills. Would you guys like to hear? They're very short.
Sure.
That might have impact on human rights. The first bill that is being debated in the Senate is that would impact the representation of everybody, which is a human right, is the Elections Omnibus Bill. This bill contains two bad clauses. One will create a provisional ballot system in Minnesota, and since we have same-day voter registration, we are exempt from having a provisional ballot system. Instead of resolving voters' issues on election day, voters will instead have to cast provisional ballots that may not be counted. This is, might be unnecessary. The second clause would make election judge party affiliations public information. And this role should be, or is a nonpartisan role, and this appears to be a change that would allow judicial decisions to be called into question for political gain. So, again, let me ask you guys, you think that that does impact the right of representation?
Yeah.
So that's something, the human rights. The other one is freedom of speech, and it's a public safety omnibus. So controversial provisions would allow the state to use for profit private prisons. Oh, that's, and it's also part of human rights. The prisons are now for profit. Prisons should be focused on rehabilitation, not keeping beds full to maximize profits. It also contains, these are important, contains two anti-protester provisions. One that increases charges for obstruction of highway or near an airport, and one for blocking transit. New penalties will be a gross misdemeanor, which is up to 1 year in prison. So, again, the United States has a long history of civil disobedience, from Boston Tea Party to Selma, and a year in prison seems excessive. In addition, the House Information Service, according to the House Information Service, this bill adds cannabinoids to the Schedule I drug list, which means that that doesn't have anything to do with the Cuban rights. Anyway, so that's basically impacts freedom of speech. And finally, this is the right to clean to food and clean water. Bill H.F. 888, it's the Environmental and Natural Resources Omnibus. This is a work, this is a meeting that it's in the conference committee. This a version of this bill is regarding the Environmental Quality Board and allows companies to draft their own environmental impact statement assessments. I know. It adds a loophole to compliance with companies to draft their compliance with riparian buffer requirements, which affect us, and which protects the water supply for farm runoff and prohibits lead shot bans. So again, you know, we don't want bans, but it does affect people. Clean water, clean food, clean environment. Just that the kind of bills you guys want to hear about.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Sounds good.
Yep. Hopefully it'll cause somebody to pick up the phone or pick up a pen and contact their state representative and state senator on these issues.
Mm-hmm. So can I have these? So yeah. Can I write down what you're saying?
Can I just ask what the status is of the report of the ad hoc committee that we made? Is that part of Ron's thing
yes.
you're talking about
yes,
going
sir.
To the city council?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, we needed to change.
Does the city council have that information? Or was Ron taking it?
That was Ron was taking it
to
the city manager. He was going to have a discussion with the mayor and talk about social media outreach in the city.
Every meeting we lose more time because this is a long-term process. Uh-huh. So we
right.
have to make sure we kind of get that going. You should at least give it to the city council so they have a chance to at least read it.
I thought there was a reason he was taking it to the city manager first.
That I'm not recalling, but all I remember is that we do need to change the ordinance before we can change our bylaws.
Right, exactly, right.
Yeah.
I think that was the reason.
It could have been the city manager just to get some insight on historical aspects of changing ordinances and such. I don't know. Can't remember.
Okay. So I will email Ron to let him know we're kind of in a time crunch for the ordinance, more so than social media outreach,
mm-hmm.
obviously.
Right.
Yeah.
See if I can light a fire that way. Anything anybody else would like to add? Anything from the members of the audience? No? You all look... like scared.
They're riveted at all the activity here today.
I was just going to say, we did get a thank you note from the United We Stand players. I apologize. I left it at home, but it was a very nice note. They all signed it and was really appreciative of this opportunity. They're still talking about it.
That was
it.
Fun.
And,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Thanks for your coming. And yep, they had a good time.
Good. Do I have anybody that would like to make a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, all opposed? Excellent. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.